Let's actually define eBPF. Like, what is it? What does that mean? What does it stand for?
So, yeah, we have to, because it's a set of letters, we have to say what it stands for. And it stands for Extended Berkeley Packet Filter. But now you can erase those words from your mind, because although it has its roots in packet filtering, it is capable of so much more that the acronym is pretty much meaningless now. So we just think of it as a term, eBPF. And what it allows us to do is run custom programs inside the kernel. I nearly said the Linux kernel. It is also possible these days to run eBPF in Windows as well. So it's becoming adopted by other operating systems. But the sort of history of it, and it's certainly, you know, most widely adopted in Linux, and that's where I'm most familiar as well. Yeah, so it allows us to write custom programs, load them dynamically into the kernel, attach them to any event on the system. And then our program could be collecting information about the event. So we might use it for observability. We can even influence the way the kernel behaves. So we can use it to do things like modify network packets or redirect network packets to build networking functionality, or potentially make policy decisions for security reasons, whether that's dropping network packets or permitting or denying certain activities to happen from a security perspective. That having the ability to modify how the kernel behaves and modify it dynamically gives us superpowers. And wow. That's kind of why I'm really excited about it.